the National Lottery In It to Win It. Tonight, with another Lotto rollover, here's your host, Dale Winton.
Thank you so much. Good evening. Welcome to the National Lottery In It to Win It. Now, is this going to be the night your life changes forever? I hope so, because with the three big lottery draws, all you need is that one lucky ticket. There's also up to £100,000 to play for here in the studio right now. And each and every one sharing that dream to take home the cash, let's welcome our five players. They are Steph. Declan. Jill. David. And Nicola. What they need to do is make it out of the waiting area to join me here in Winner's Row. If they do that, I could well be handing them a cheque for a lot of money. So, who will be the first person sitting in Winner's Row? You each have your own colour. Let's find out who's going to play first. Nicola, come and make some money!
First across to Winner's Row tonight is 31-year-old Nicola from East London. She's a civil servant.
Hi, good morning. How are you? Come on. All for you. Tell me, this is the seat you wanted, isn't it?
Yes, definitely.
The first seat. Are you going to stay here?
Hopefully, Dale.
You stay here till the klaxon goes, you know you're going to get a crack at the share of the prize fund. Who did you bring with you for support?
I brought my dad and my brother Ian.
Two cool dudes up there, looking very cool. Okay, so how much do you want to go home with tonight?
Oh, I'd go home with 15,000 tonight, Dale.
15?
15.
In terms of In It to Win It, that is quite modest.
I know.
People sometimes go home with a lot more. So what do you want to do with the money?
My boyfriend and I bought a flat last year, and I think we'd like to do it up because it needs serious renovations. And I'd also like to buy an old... No, second-hand car. Well, actually, no, a brand-new car.
You did quite right, Steve, quite right. Now, hang on, did I not hear right that your boyfriend won't let you drive his car?
He lets me drive it, but I think he thinks of my liability in his car. I think he's always, like, basically looking at it and worried that I'm going to crash it.
OK. Yeah. So you have your own car?
Yes.
OK, so I think you might need a bit more than 15 grand.
Yeah.
Maybe 30, 40, 50 grand.
That'd be even better.
And you'd still buy the car and do the house up. Where would you start with the house? With the upstairs, the downstairs?
I start with the kitchen, followed by the bathroom, followed by the garden, then followed by the bedrooms, for everything.
You want the whole thing done?
Yeah.
That's good. Well, we need to put some money in the prize fund. Here's how it goes. Every question I ask you tonight will be worth 5 grand in the prize fund if you give me the right answer. If you give me the wrong answer, you know what I'm going to say. You go to the red area. Two ways out of there on the turn of one question, back here in Winner's Row or right back where you started. We're not going to do that, are we?
No.
OK, darling. Shall we do your first question?
OK, then.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Let's have a look at your first question. Nicola, in which part of the body is a scorpion's sting? Oh, that's interesting. Is it pincer, tail or antennae?
Oh.
A scorpion's sting, what part of its body is it?
Well, Dale, I'm sure it's not the antennae. Actually, I didn't even think scorpions had antennae. So I'm going to eliminate that. And I don't think it's the pincers. I'm going to go for the tail.
OK, I accept tail. If that is right, we will have 5 grand in the prize fund. Is the answer tail? Yes! Well done. Are you a scorpion? What sign are you?
I'm an Aries.
Aries, oh, that's good. OK. Right, there's 5 grand in here. If you get this one right, it'll be £10,000. Here's your second question. Until they broke up in 2004, who was the boyfriend of the fashion doll Barbie? Would it be Ken, Chris, or Dave? Until they broke up in 2004, who was the boyfriend of the fashion doll Barbie?
Well, actually, Dale, I had a Barbie when I was younger, so I think I might know this one, so I'm going to go for Ken. That rings a bell from last about 7.
Okay. If it's Ken, there'll be another 5 grand in the prize fund. Is the answer Ken? Yes! 10 grand. Okay, darling. This would make it 15,000. This will be your third correct answer. Okay. Let's do it. Here's your question. John Motson is famous for commentating on which televised sport? Would it be darts, cricket, or football? Any good?
Well, isn't John Motson always wear that heavy coat outside? So it can't be darts. And I think cricket usually is commentated by someone who's an ex-cricketer, someone like Ian Botha. I'm going to go for football, Dale.
Would you like me to take football as your answer?
Yes, Dale, yeah.
OK, I accept football. If you are right, you cracked it. Another £5,000, 15,000 in the prize fund. Nicola, did you give me the right answer? Yes! What a bit of a roll here. This is going rather well. OK, £15,000. No one to share it with. You're on your own in winner's row. You're playing the perfect game. Let's see if we can make it 20 grand. Here's your next question. The Bollywood film industry is based in which Indian city? Is it Delhi, Mumbai, or Kolkata?
Well, that's a tough one, Dale.
Well, back up the bus, relax, take it steady, and don't give me an answer till you're ready.
I've actually no idea about this one. I think... none of them rings a bell at all. So, this might have to be a guess, Dale.
OK.
I might have to risk it and go for a guess.
You've worked everything out quite well so far. Is there no logic to this at all?
Not at all, actually. None at all. There's no... I can't even... I don't even know where to start.
OK.
So, I think I might have to go for Mumbai.
Would you like me to take Mumbai as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
Consider it done. Nicola, you say Mumbai. I hope you're right, and if you are, you've dodged a bullet, you didn't like this one. However, it will be worth £20,000 in the prize fund. Will it be 20 grand? Is it Mumbai? Yes! Well done! Well done! This will be 25 grand, which will be fabulous. Here's your next question, Nicola. From what is the medicinal and cosmetic substance aloe vera derived? Oh, is it? Cow hides? Fish? Or plants? Aloe vera, the medicinal and cosmetic substance, where does it come from?
Right, I'm trying to think of shampoo bottles, because they've always got aloe vera written over them or something like that. So, I don't think they obviously show cow hides. Now, fish, well, I don't think it'd be fish. I think, like, it's going to be plants. They always show, like, twigs and stuff growing on shampoo bottles. So I'm going to go for plants.
Would you like me to take plants as your answer, Nicola?
Yes, Dale.
I shall. I accept plants, if that's right. There will be 25 grand in the prize fund. Is the answer plants? Yes! They're ever so pleased with you up there. Ever so pleased with you up there. Look at Dad. OK, you are a quarter of a way to 100 grand. Isn't that extraordinary?
No.
And you're on your own. You don't have to share it with anybody. OK, shall we make it 30 grand?
Yes, Dale, definitely.
Come on, let's do it. Here's your question. The pop singer Shakira was born in which country? Was it Japan, South Africa, or Colombia?
Well... Shakira doesn't sound like a Japanese name, so I'm going to rule that out.
Now, do you like her music?
A couple of tracks is okay, yeah. Not bad. Oh, dear. I don't think it's South Africa. Mind you, a name like Shakira, it could be. Right, I'm going to go for Colombia, Dale. I'm going to go for Colombia.
Would you like me to accept Colombia as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
I shall. I've accepted Colombia, which means that if you're right, you will have answered six on the go, £30,000 in the prize fund. Shakira, is she Colombian? Yeah! She's gorgeous. I love Shakira. We could make it 35 grand.
Okay.
Shall we do it?
Yes, to do it.
Come on, Nicola, let's have a look at your next question. What type of clothing is a tam o' shanter? Is it a hat, a dress, or an overcoat?
Oh.
Tam o' shanter any good?
I have absolutely no idea, dear. Absolutely no idea.
We've been here before, though, with the no idea business. You keep on telling me, and we're sailing through.
I know. This one is oh, this one's going to be potluck. Well, I don't think it's a hat. I've never heard of a tam o' shanter as a hat. And I haven't even heard of a dress or an overcoat, to be honest. Tam o' shanter. Tam o' shanter. Something's saying to me overcoat, but that's just a guess. I can't imagine that a dress could actually be called tam o' shanter. Oh, something's screaming overcoat. Could be wrong. I'm going to go overcoat. I have no idea why. It's a guess. I'm going to go overcoat.
Would you like me to take overcoat as your answer, Nicola?
Yes, Dale.
OK. I accept overcoat. If that is right, we will have £35,000 in the prize fund. Is the answer overcoat? That's a hat. Oh, look, they love you. They're really upset you got that one wrong. Please, for now, make your way to red. Well, Nicola has set her other players up brilliantly with 30-odd grand in the prize fund. One of them is about to join me here in Winner's Row. Who's it going to be? Let's find out. Cielo, it's David!
Yes!
Come and make some money!
Next over is accounts executive David, who's 26 and from Leeds.
Good to see you. Come and sit down. Well, you were very patient over there.
Keeping my seat warm, Dale.
Absolutely. And look what she did for you. Nicola put 30 grand in the prize fund.
Fantastic.
How much do you want to go home with tonight?
Oh, definitely about 20,000, Dale.
You do, which definitely. Is great. And what do you want to do with the 20 grand?
Well, Dale, it's my dream to do an acting course, so I'd love to spend the money on that.
So you're going to give up what you do and study acting? You
definitely.
Want to be an actor?
It's my dream. My dream.
Oh, really? How fantastic is that? And you need 20 grand for that?
Oh, thereabouts, I think, definitely.
It's a precarious occupation, you know? It really is. Do you want to do stage or movies? What would you like to do?
I'd love to do stage, definitely.
You would?
Yeah.
Who's your favourite actor?
It's definitely Robert De Niro.
Fantastic. Well, you've got to follow your dream. Who did you bring with you for support tonight?
I brought my girlfriend Suzanne and my sister Jenny.
Which one's which?
Suzanne's on the left.
Hi, ladies, looking lovely. So, do they get a treat? If you win, say, 40 grand, do they get anything?
I would definitely take Suzanne on holiday.
You would?
Definitely, and take my sister out for a nice meal.
She gets a meal and that's it?
She's a sister.
She's a sister. Fair enough. Well, you're looking at 30 grand at the moment. You don't even have to worry about your question yet. You're only here because Nicola got the answer wrong. I've got to get her out of the red area, back here in Winner's Row. I'll be back with your question in a moment. Nicola.
Hi, Dale.
This is dangerous. There's jeopardy here.
Yeah.
Because no multiple choice. One question, you have to find the answer. If you give me the right one, you're going back alongside David in Winner's Row, which is where you belong. You put in 30 grand. So, if you're ready, shall we do your question?
Yeah, let's go. Let's do it.
Wish you the best of luck. Here's your question. OK. What is the full name of the common ailment usually referred to as the flu? Full name of the flu.
I think, Dale. Oh my gosh. I'm going to go for the common cold.
Are you saying you would like me to take common cold as your answer?
Yes, Dale. I've no other answer. I can't think of anything else.
Okay. I accept common cold. What is the full name of the common ailment usually referred to as the flu? Is influenza. I was sure you were going to get that. But for now, Nicola, I'm sorry, please make your way right back where you started. That was a shocker.
It was.
I was sure she was going to get that right. Here's your turn. You join me in Winner's Row with £30,000 in the prize fund. Let's make it 35 grand. Are you ready?
Yes, Dale.
Let's have a look at your question. Who gave birth to a baby named Princess Tiami in June 2007? Was it Jordan, Gwyneth Paltrow, or Victoria Beckham?
Well, I know this one. I've been watching them on TV.
Oh, you haven't?
Yeah. I've been watching them on TV. They've got their baby diaries. And she had the baby with Peter Andre. It's Jordan.
Would you like me to take Jordan as the answer?
Yes, Dale.
I accept Jordan as the answer. If it is right, there will be 35 grand in the prize fund. Is it Jordan? Yes! Let's make it 40 grand. Here's your next question. How often are US presidential elections held? Would it be every 2 years, every 4 years, or every 6 years? The US presidential elections.
Dale, I think it's a lot like the UK, so they serve a term of, I think, 4 years. So I think it would definitely be every 4 years. Not six, not two, definitely four.
So, David, are you saying you'd like me to take four as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
OK, I accept 4 years. If that's right, 40 grand in the prize fund. That's a very healthy prize fund. Is the answer 4 years?
Yes!
All right, isn't it? I dare look over my left shoulder. I dare not look. Steph, how are you doing, darling?
I'm good. I'd rather be over there, though.
I can imagine. Who did you bring with you for support?
I've got my dad, Rod, and my friend, Tom.
Hi, guys. Declan, you look fidgety earlier. I was looking at
just
you.
Just itching to get off this seat and make that march across the end chairs.
You come all the way from Ireland.
And, you know, this short distance is sort of way, you know, it's getting in my head here at the moment.
I love the strong Irish brogue. I love it. Jill!
Hello, Dale.
Oh, darling, how you doing?
I want to be over there.
I can imagine. Who did you bring with you for support?
My darling daughter, Jan, and my lovely son-in-law, Keith.
Cool, that's good. Nicola, are you OK?
I'm fine, Dale, I'm fine.
Surviving? Well... Are you ready?
Yes, Dale.
Come on, let's have a look at your next question. In 2007, which tennis player became the first Briton to win a senior Wimbledon title for 20 years? Was it Jamie Murray, Elena Baltacha, or Tim Henman?
Sad to say, I think it's definitely not Tim Henman. He didn't win it, I don't think. But I do remember reading something in the papers about Jamie Murray winning a doubles title with one of his colleagues. So my final answer is Jamie Murray.
Would you like me to accept Jamie Murray as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
I accept Jamie Murray. If that is right, we'll have 45,000 in the prize fund. Is it Jamie Murray?
Yes!
You're doing well. This would make it £50,000.
Wow.
Are you ready?
Yes, Dale.
Here's your question. What type of creature is a minke? Is it an ape, a snake, or a whale? Is it any good?
Wow. Well, I don't think it's a snake, Dale. It doesn't shout snake to me. I think it's either an ape. It could be an ape or it could be a whale. But as I don't know the answer, I'm going to take a guess and say a whale.
Would you like me to accept whale as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
OK. David says whale. I'll accept that. It would be the magical 50 grand if you'd given me the right answer. I hope so. Is the answer whale?
Yes!
How did you do that? It just came to you.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have known where to begin with that one. You've cracked the magical 50 grand and you're on your own in winner's row, which you know what that means. If the klaxon were to go right now, no one to share it with. One question and it's all yours.
Wow.
Shall we make it 55,000?
Yes.
Come on, let's have a look at your question. The circus troupe known as Cirque du Soleil was founded in which country? Was it Mexico, Canada, or USA?
Wow.
You're smiling, is that good?
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, I think I know the answer. I think I know the answer, but of course I could be wrong. It's Cirque du Soleil, that's kind of a French influence, and I think parts of Canada, French-speaking Canada. I don't think it's Mexico. I think it's between Canada and USA, and with the French in the name, I just think Canada.
Is that the answer you would like me to take?
Yes, Dale.
I accept Canada. If it's right, 55 grand. Is the answer Canada? Yes! Have you ever seen Cirque du Soleil? That's wonderful. Oh, you have to. You have to go and see. It's wonderful. This is getting very grown up and very serious, isn't it?
Very.
Look at that. 55 grand in the prize fund. We're all looking very cool up there. This would be 60,000. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's have a look at your question. What is the name of the historic boundary that runs along the border between England and Wales? Is it Hadrian's Wall, the Ridgeway, or Offa's Dyke?
I can get rid of Hadrian's Wall to start with, because I know that's between England and Scotland. So it's either the Ridgeway or Offa's Dyke. And for some reason, Offa's Dyke is jumping out at me. Definitely. I've no idea why. I'm sure I must have heard it somewhere. But between England and Wales, I'm going to go Offa's Dyke.
Am I to take Offa's Dyke as your answer?
Yes, please.
You've got a real glint in your eye when you said that. You kind of like, you feel sure about this, don't you? I've accepted Offa's Dyke. If it is correct, fabulous, 60 grand in the prize fund. Is it Offa's Dyke? Yes! You knew that. You kind of knew that. Okay. This would be £65,000.
It's a lot of money.
It's a lot of money. Are you ready?
Yes, Dale.
Let's have the question. What is the first name of Professor Moriarty, the arch enemy of Sherlock Holmes? Is it James, Henry, or Charles? Professor Moriarty.
I've seen Sherlock Holmes on TV, but I've always heard of Moriarty as his surname. I don't know his first name, so...
James. Well, take your time on this. This would not be a good time to end up in red.
Henry Moriarty doesn't sound quite right. James... Again, I think Charles is crying out for me. Definitely. If I was to guess between James and Charles, I'd say Charles, though.
Is that a guess you want me to accept as your answer?
Yes, though.
OK. I accept Charles. If that is right, there will be £65,000 in the prize fund. Is it Charles? It's James. Isn't it funny how you ruled out Henry and it was between the other two and you weren't quite sure? And the audience are so with you, the R's, they don't want to see you go to red, but I have to say, for now, please make your way to red. It's a very tense game tonight, but I still have an empty seat here in Winner's Row. Who will fill it? Let's find out. It's green, it's Declan.
Yes! It's Declan's turn. He's a 43-year-old DJ from Carrickfergus in County Antrim.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Come and sit down. Out of all the players, you were the one that was looking like, is it ever going to be my turn?
Yeah, I've travelled all the way from Northern Ireland. Yeah, fantastic.
Apparently it was worth the trip.
It was worth the trip. Haven't the guys done fantastic?
Well, look at that.
Yeah.
Nicola and David have put 30 grand in a piece, 60 grand, and here you are in Winner's Row.
No pressure.
No pressure. Who did you bring with you for support?
I brought my sister, Geraldine, and the niece, Katie.
Lovely. Lovely ladies up there. How much would you like to take home tonight?
It wouldn't be greedy, Dale. 20,000 would be a nice start.
OK, but, you know, there's 60 in there now.
Yeah, I know, but I would like to see some of these other guys coming down and joining us.
What would you like to do with 20 grand?
Well, I have two beautiful daughters, Danielle and Alicia, and Alicia's just 2 years old. She's special needs. She's Down syndrome. So if I won anything this evening, I would like to give a share of that away to the Down Syndrome Association.
Brilliant.
So I would. And the two girls, thank you. The two girls haven't been away on a holiday in 9 years. When I say a holiday in 9 years, I mean they've never actually been on a flight in 9 years.
They've never been on a plane, have they?
No, they haven't been on a plane. So obviously, if I won enough this evening, Disney World, Orlando, Florida, here we come. Pack the
fabulous,
bags.
Fabulous,
fabulous.
Actually,
yeah.
Listening to you talk, I know you're a DJ.
Yeah.
And I can hear this great. I could listen to you forever.
Why?
Well, it's the, what's the voice?
Oh, it's right. Okay.
What did you think I meant?
Oh well. Hey, Dancing Dex Road Show.
You're turning into Smashy and Nicey
now,
aren't you?
Smashy and Nicey,
you are.
Road
you
show,
are.
Yeah.
But you're very welcome.
That's very kind of you, Dale.
Thank
you very much. You
can relax for a moment because you're only here because, well, David got the answer wrong. I've got to get him out of the red area, back here in Winners Row. I'll return with your first question in a moment. First of all, David, you know how it works in the red area. One question, this will not be multiple choice. If you find the right answer, you're back with Declan in Winners Row. Come on, let's have a look at the question. Which character was played by Tony Robinson in the Blackadder comedy series? You're smiling.
I know this one, Dale. I love Blackadder.
You do?
Very, very funny. And Tony Robinson plays the character Baldrick, who's very funny. Definitely, definitely Baldrick.
Would you like me to take Baldrick as your answer?
I would, Dale, yes.
You look like do it now, please, Dale. Get on with it. OK. I accept Baldrick as the answer. If that is right, you'll be back in Winners Row alongside Declan. Is the answer Baldrick? Yes!
Yes!
You knew that one. Come on, Dave. Come on back. OK. There's two of you in Winners Row. You're looking at 30 grand apiece. That's very, very healthy.
Absolutely.
You've yet to answer a question.
Yeah.
Come on, Declan, let's look at your first question.
OK.
Which actress was featured in the title of a UK number one hit single by Mika in 2007? You're a DJ. What is this? It's a gift.
Yeah.
Is it Grace Kelly, Ava Gardner, or Rita Hayworth?
No, you're right, I'm a DJ. So, I knew the answer to this one, actually, before the answers even come up.
OK.
OK? So, I can absolutely rule out Ava Gardner and Rita Hayworth, and I would like you to take Grace Kelly as my answer. And anybody that listens to the start of the track, it's actually mentioned in the first few bars of the track.
Oh, is it? You're showing off now.
Yeah, well...
OK. Would you like me to take Grace Kelly as your answer?
Yes, please, Dale.
I love Mika, but is it Grace Kelly? For another £5,000, please reveal the answer. Yes, you knew that. It's a great record. Well done.
Thank you.
Would you have liked that one, David?
I would have.
Yeah, everybody knows that record. It's great. This would be £70,000, which would round it up nicely. That would be £35,000 apiece. OK, you ready?
Yep.
Come on, let's have a look at your question. The former Manchester United midfielder Roy Keane became the manager of which club in 2006? Would it be West Ham, Wigan, or Sunderland? Footy fan?
I'm an Arsenal supporter, Dale.
I'm giving you a high five. There you go.
And I know this one. I've got a very good friend who's a fan of the club that he manages. And I know that Roy Keane went to Sunderland.
Would you like me to take that as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
David says Sunderland. Let's see the answer.
Yes!
OK, £70,000, you're looking at £35,000 apiece. Are you ready for your next question?
Getting scary, yeah.
Are you
absolutely
scared, Declan?
No, not scared,
well,
I'm afraid.
The last question was very good for you. A music
certainly
question.
Was, yeah.
Let's see what this one is. For another £5,000, the San Andreas Fault, a major fracture in the Earth's crust, runs through which US state? You are smiling.
Yep.
Is it Texas, California, or Florida?
OK, the reason I'm smiling, OK, I watch a lot of the James Bond films. And there was one film which was based around the San Andreas Fault. And I would have to rule out Texas and Florida and go straight for California.
Would you like me to take California as your answer?
Absolutely.
Consider it done. I accept California. If you are right and James Bond didn't let you down, there'll be £75,000 in the prize fund. Is the answer California?
Yes!
You did it. This would be £80,000. This is very serious. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's have a look at your next question. Which type of drink takes its name from a German word for storehouse or storage? Is it beer, ale, or lager? Which type of drink takes its name from a German word for storehouse or storage? Beer, ale, or lager?
Well, one answer jumps out at me, Dale. But I don't know if it's right. I just have an inkling that it might be this one. And I don't think it's beer. I don't think it's ale. I think it's lager. It seems to me that that could be one of the only ones that kind of comes from German language. So, lager.
Am I to take lager as your answer?
Yes, Dale.
Okay. I accept lager. So far tonight, David, you have put £35,000 in the prize fund. If you give me the correct answer, your contribution will be £40,000. Will be half of the prize fund just by you alone. We need this one to be right. Doesn't sound like you like this question. Late in the game to get it wrong. For another £5,000, making £80,000 in the prize fund, please tell me the answer's lager.
Yes!
No, I thought it sounds like lager. That's what I say, lager. Okay, £80,000. That's the. Oh! It's a whiteout, the klaxon has sounded, that means only one thing. That prize fund is now frozen at £80,000. Guys, you're both looking at a potential share of £40,000 apiece. Relax. Ladies, I don't know what to say to you.
No.
Nicola, you put £30,000 into the prize fund. Your contribution was phenomenal. Jill and Steph, you've both been gracious and patient. And I have to say, with heavy heart, ladies, it's good night. I'm so sorry. Good night, girls. Good night, darling. £80,000, you're looking at £40,000 apiece. You are one question away from your share of that money. You can relax. I'll be back with that question in just a moment. Well done, guys. They were great. And now they're going to wait for what is probably going to be the longest couple of minutes of their life. But here's your turn to be a winner, which means let's join Duncan at Lottery HQ for tonight's Thunderball and Dream Number Draws.
National Lottery HQ on this Saturday, the 27th of October. And here's the man with two first names, Duncan James.
Thank you, Alan, and a big welcome to the National Lottery draws. A little bit later on, we've got another Saturday Night Lotto rollover, but before we get to that, Alan, what would you think if I said spring forward, fall back?
Hey, I thought it was some sort of keep fit routine, because I'm in pretty good shape, you know. I do all the exercises, I do.
Well, of course you do, Alan, of course you do. But actually, that phrase is a useful reminder to everybody at home that it's the end of British summertime tomorrow morning. So at 2 o'clock in the morning, you need to put your clocks back 1 hour and say goodbye to this year's summer. Well, if you can call it that.
Yeah, it wasn't the best, was it? No. But thanks for that timely reminder, Duncan.
Well, talking of time, Alan, how don't we better crack in with tonight's show?
Oh, yeah, let's do it, shall we?
In that case, here's tonight's Thunderball. The very dapper draw master Matt is here to oversee tonight's draws. How are you this evening?
Very well, thank you.
Had a nice week?
Yeah, very good, thanks.
Good, good, good. Well, fantastic. Alan, it's over to you.
Matt, release the balls, please, if you would. 34 balls in this first machine. In a moment, we'll pick five of them. We're using Excalibur and set of balls number 3, which were chosen for us at random earlier today by Lee Parsons from Erith. And the latest news from the draw team is that 132,000 tickets won a Thunderball prize on Wednesday night. 4 tickets did very well indeed, matching with the first 5 balls to win £5,000 apiece. Well done, Duncan.
Well, Drawmaster Matt, are we clear to proceed?
Yes, we are.
Then it's good luck, everybody.
And for tonight's live draws, our independent adjudicator, Cam Coulard, ladies and gentlemen. And there is the first one, 21. And the next one, this Saturday night. Looks a bit like that. Up she comes, that's 19. The third one to be drawn, our selector chooses for us, that one, which is 28. We need a couple more from this, our first machine. There's the first look, number 11. And then to complete the set, how about that one there, number 3. OK, then, Matt, sidle over to the second machine, if you would now, please. Start that one up and release the 14 red thunderballs. Now, matching with one of these red balls as well could be very good news. Duncan?
Yes, it could be. Remember that if you've matched all the numbers drawn so far, you need to match with this next one as well to be with a chance of winning the top prize of £250,000. It's the all-important Thunderball. And even if you've only got one number drawn so far, then matching with this next ball will make you a winner. So, good luck.
Here we go. Good luck from me too. Which one's going to be? Let's find out. Up she comes, and that is number 9. So, here are tonight's Thunderball numbers again. We put them in ascending order. 3, 11, 19, 21 and 28. The Thunderball, number 9. Duncan.
Thank you, Adam. Well, it's that time we go green for dream number. And don't forget that all the good cause money raised from Dream Number is helping to fund the London 2012 Olympic Games and Paralympic Games. Drawmaster Matt, we're clear to proceed?
Yes, we are.
Then good luck, everybody.
And tonight we're using Aventurine and Sedibles 4, again chosen by that Lee character. And the news from Wednesday's Dream Number draw is that over 42,000 winning tickets shared over 600 grand in prizes. One ticket matched all the seven numbers in sequence to win the top prize. £500,000, would you believe? If some of that cash came your way, congratulations from all of us. Back to tonight and live now on BBC One, here is this weekend's Dream Number draw. 2 is the first digit. If you match with that number, you're definitely in the game tonight. £2 is yours. There's an 8. If you match with that one as well, just won a crisp tenner for your trouble. That is a 6. Don't forget, though, there are 7 tiers of prize money in this game, ranging from £2 to that cool £500,000. There's a 0. Don't forget, too, in this game, you have a 1 in 10 chance of winning a prize. There's another 6. Maybe you need to match these numbers in sequence and with no breaks in the chain. And another 6. One more number to be drawn, which will be the last in the sequence tonight. The answer's right there, it's a 0. So tonight's National Lottery dream number is 2, 8, 6, 0, 6, 6, 0. Mr. James.
Well, that's it for now, but we'll be back shortly with tonight's daily play results, and we've got another big Lotto rollover draw. But for now, it's straight back to In It To Win It with the three Ds, Dale, Declan and David. See you soon. Don't forget, the Lotto draw is still to come. First of all, these two people helped put £80,000 in the prize fund, which means they're each looking at a share of at least £40,000. And you know what? They're just one question away from that cash. Declan, you sat in the waiting area forever and a day, it seemed. Very patient.
Yep.
A bit fidgety and twitchy, if you don't mind me saying so.
I'm fidgety and twitchy, but anybody that knows me, that's just the way I am.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter. The result is you're looking at the prize fund of £80,000.
Fantastic.
Your share of that is 40.
Yeah.
If you give me the right answer, in fact, if you both give me the right answer, the minimum you're going home with is that 40K. You put in 10 grand, so you've earned your right to be here.
Okay.
One question separates you from that cash.
Okay.
It's that moment where we can't put it off any longer, can we?
Yeah, we might as well have a look at it, Dale, and see what the form is.
See what the form is. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Declan, I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks, Dale.
We're all with you. Everybody in the room, everybody up there.
Thank you.
Here's your question. Annika Sorenstam and Michelle Wee are major figures in which sport?
Right.
Is it golf? Is it tennis or is it athletics?
Okay, I know this one. Okay? I'm shaking.
You're right.
It's not tennis, it's not athletics, and it's golf. Sorry, I'm getting a bit.
Oh, don't get upset.
It's okay, no problem. I'm just excited because it's golf. Please take that as a final answer.
I've accepted golf. If that is right, you came here with a dream. You're going to give some money to the Down Syndrome organisation.
Absolutely.
You're going to take the kids away on holiday.
Absolutely.
It all rests on this.
Yep.
If indeed the answer is golf, you're looking at £40,000. Declan, are you going home with the money? Well done, well done. How are you feeling? You okay?
I am so stoked up, it is unbelievable. It's just a dream come true, Dale. That's it. I'm sorry. But... Thank you.
Fantastic. David.
Dale.
Tonight, you have given me 8 correct answers. You have put in £40,000 in the prize fund. Above every other player,
you've put in the most. More than anybody else, you have the right to be here in Winner's Row. Declan has just given me a right answer. He's going home with that 40 grand. You can do the same. It's yours for the taking. As you know, there's one question that separates you from that cash. Here, for £40,000, is your question. Which is the largest Australian state covering approximately a third of the country? Is it New South Wales, Queensland, or Western Australia? Oh, any good?
Not really, Dale. But I'm gonna just think through it. There's two that jump out to me. It's Queensland and Western Australia. But,
I'll repeat the question, it may help. Which is the largest Australian state covering approximately a third of the country? New South Wales, Queensland, Western Australia.
Okay. I really do think it's Queensland or Western Australia, but I don't know which one to go with. But I've got to go with one.
Well, just take your time.
New South Wales, Queensland, Western Australia. I'm just trying to visualize the map. Okay. I'm going to go with Queensland.
Are you saying you would like me to accept Queensland as your answer? No, that's fair enough. It's fair enough. It's your choice. It's your decision. Have you ever been to Australia?
No. Not at all. I'll go with Western Australia then.
Would you like me to take Western Australia as your answer?
Yes, Dale, but I'm not looking.
Okay. I accept Western Australia as your answer. You ruled out New South Wales. You're vacillating between Queensland and Western Australia. I have no idea why you came down on the side of Western Australia, but if you made the right choice, very shortly I'll be handing you a cheque for £40,000. If it's wrong, that 40 grand will go to Declan and he'll get a cheque for £80,000. That is what's at stake here. For £40,000, David wants to know, is the answer Western Australia?
Yes! Yes!
I can't believe it.
Well done!
I can't believe it.
Believe it.
You did it.
That's the perfect result. Oh, fantastic. You can relax. I shall return with your checks very soon.
Thank you.
Another great night on In It To Win It. But you know what? It isn't over yet. You could be moments away from winning a fortune yourself. So let's cross over to Duncan at Lottery HQ for Saturday night's big lotto draw.
Thank you very much, Dan, and welcome back to Lottery HQ. We'll have tonight's Lotto rollover draw in just a moment. But first, before we came on air, the draw team alongside an independent adjudicator carried out today's, or tonight's, Daily Play draw, and Alan has the results.
I have. Today's Daily Play winning numbers are these. 1, 4, 12, 15, 19, 20, and 22. Duncan.
And remember that you can see the Daily Play draw every weekday evening for around 9:30 p.m. just by logging on to bbc.co.uk/lottery. Now, Alan, can I have a final summertime time check, please?
Oh, don't remind me. It's 9:15 now.
Well, in that case, I make it time for Lotto. So, Alan, This is the moment that could change someone's life forever. Could you please tell me tonight's rollover lotto jackpot?
Yeah, tonight, Duncan, we're playing for an estimated jackpot. £7.6 million.
Woo, fantastic. Well, good luck to you all. Alan, take it away.
Let's release those rollover balls. Set of balls four inside Amethyst, in fact. And the news from the draw team is that over 309,000 tickets won a prize on Wednesday night, sharing over £5.3 million in prizes. So, another rollover on our hands. Here we go, then. It's the 220th time that the jackpot has rolled. Duncan.
Drawmaster Matt, are we clear to proceed?
Yes, we are.
Fantastic news. Good luck to you all.
Tonight's lottery update, 10:30 tonight, after the news and just before Match of the Day. There's number 8, the first one. Last joined us just the 5 Wednesdays back, 176th time it's appeared in this game we call Lotto. And the next is right there. That's number 32, 158th time as a main Lotto ball. We saw it the Wednesday before last as well. Next, out pops another one. That's number 13, lucky for somebody tonight. Last with us just a half dozen Wednesdays back, that one, 130th time as a main ball. And the next is number 22, selected the Wednesday before last as well. You'll recall that if it's one of yours, 179th time we've seen it now. Next is that one there, number 10. Also joined us the Wednesday before last, 179th time. That one's been drawn, and the sixth one that could make you very rich. It's right there. It is, in fact, number 6 itself. Last saw that 3 Saturdays ago, 158th time now, as a Lotto main ball. The bonus tonight is number 3. So this weekend's winning Lotto numbers are 6, 8, 10, 13, 22, and 32. The bonus, number 3. Duncan.
Well, that's it for us here at Lottery HQ for tonight. Don't forget, Mylene Clark will be back on Wednesday about 10:35 for the midweek draws. And I'll be back next Saturday night with those all-important numbers. Remember that you can log on to the latest lottery news just by logging on to bbc.co.uk/lottery. And I hope that tonight's numbers have been brought you luck. So all that's left for me to say is good night, and don't forget to change those clocks back at 2 o'clock. Back to Dale. To me to do now is to give Declan and David their checks for a massive £40,000 each. Talk about when Irish eyes are smiling. Look at you.
My eyes are smiling.
This check says, please pay Declan Cleary £40,000. I'm delighted. Well done.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
No, for me too. For me as well.
Thank you very much.
Well done. Thank you. Thank you. Look at this. David Williamson, 40 grand. A career in acting, I think, beckons.
Let's hope so.
Just what you want. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dale.
You are so welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome. Our winners. Fantastic. Fantastic. They both have their checks, and another great night it's been on In It to Win It. Don't forget to join me next Saturday to see if I can give some more big money away. Until then, have a great night. Good night.